Back to another edition of the Kills Talk TV podcast, where today we're going to be going through these absolutely horrendous results that we've been having. We're going to be going through in each game this season. I'm just going to be having a wee kind of mini review in each game, and then we'll have a wee kind of preview on the Berwick game and the Motherwell game for Saturday. So, why are we playing this bad? I don't have a clue. Start of the season, everybody was feeling dead positive about the players we were bringing in. We brought back Chris Boyd, we brought in Higginbotham, we brought in, you know, Lee McCock as an experienced defender, we brought in Jamie McDonald, who's easily been our best player this season. There's no doubt about that. Nobody else is even trying. Right, so Dundee game, we're going in to the stadium hoping to get 3 points. Start the game, we're getting the ball away every time we get it. We can't even string 3 passes together. Dundee go up 2-0 at half time. You're thinking, right, come out second half. Maybe that was just a bad half. Hopefully we come out again, maybe get back into the game. What is it? I don't know, 50 seconds or something at the second half, 3-0 Dundee, another 5 minutes, 10 minutes later, 4-0 Dundee. I was fucking raging, right? Excuse the language, but Jesus Christ. I thought that was the worst game I've seen since got to the Kill games in ages, mate, apart from the League Cup final in 2007. That game was just horrendous. But the fact, the Dundee game is probably worse than that. Anyway, so I can't even remember what I did after that. 4-0 Dundee. That's what I did. I just went in and just went to the toilets for like 10 minutes. I was just so annoyed. I didn't even want to come back out. So I came back up and then I just stood at the railings. This is in the East Stand, by the way. So I just stood at the railings. And I was just like looking at the position of the players. And I started to see this in a couple of games. See, at first I thought it was Hamill. Hamill was all over the place. Did it in the Aberdeen game as well. I was just looking at Hamill, and then some stupid steward said, "Could you please take a seat?" See this, by the way, see this ticket thing? They need to scrap it. They should just be pay at the gate, that's you. None of this bloody you need to pay in advance. Shite. That is just, there's no need for that. What Gordon said in his rant video, which, good for him, it went viral. Good to get the word out there as well. About how bad we're playing. He said this whole, the Ross County game, right, we had 3,600 fans. We've got 3,000 season ticket holders. There was 120 Ross County fans, which means there was about, say, 480 Killie fans that turned up that day who were on the season ticket holders. What does that tell you? It tells you that fans can't be arsed waiting for tickets. It tells you that fans aren't impressed by the way we're playing. And it tells you that, I don't bloody know. It tells you that we're just absolutely shite. This has been the worst start to a season I can ever think of. Anyway, so, what's 4-0 to Dundee? You think we can improve? We got to Aberdeen the next week, take about 100 fans, no winner. I've only gone on for 4 minutes. We're playing, I wouldn't say we're playing well, but we've not conceded in the first 10 minutes of the game. Was a terrible goal. And the left back just runs by about 40 players. And it's an easy goal. Terrible goal for us to concede. So you're thinking, we've only conceded one this time, hopefully we can go out and get an equaliser. Aberdeen get a penalty. A lot of folks said it was a dive, but I don't think it was. I think it was apparently. Ashcroft just sliding in. He's been absolutely horrendous. Not just him, but I'll go on to everybody else in a minute. Aberdeen make it 2-0. So that's game by, that's that game done. Then Celtic comes up. You're expected 4-5-0. Opening 3 minutes of the game, Griffiths scores 1-0. You're thinking this has got to be a long 90 minutes. And then 20-25 minutes into the game, we start creating chances. Josh misses a sitter. And then at the end of the first half, Josh gets a goal. So you're thinking that we're really starting to, you know, strengthen for the season. We don't play as good as we were at the end of the first half, but the start of the second half we were doing better than we were against Aberdeen and Dundee. Then Beaton, just you can't even beat on that kind of space, right? You know, he has got a good shot on him, and he showed that when he just did an absolute wonder goal at the top corner. And I seen some guy in the fan page saying Samson could have caught that or something. Samson couldn't catch a cold, never mind a body shot. So I don't know what he was thinking. Jamie McDonald couldn't save it. It was a good goal. And then we start getting into the game again. We get a bit of luck with the penalty. I think, in my opinion, it's a bit of a soft penalty, but we get the penalty. And then Higgy, which is got to be at least, it's got to be the penalty of the season, unless somebody does a body Ibrahimovic and hits it into the top corner and it gets caught in the net or something. So we get a point against Celtic, so then you think we can go to Partick in North County, we can get six, at least 4 points. So we got to Partick, my first away game of the season actually was Partick. Again, early goal, 3 minutes, no was it 3 minutes, I think it was 8 minutes or nine, Doolin, again just defenders slipping out each other. Christ knows what are them. Was a goal after the first 10 minutes anyway. Then a smart free kick by Higgy. Play through to Rory and he scores, makes it 1-1. Right, so we're starting to play well again at the end of the first half, right? Come out second half playing amazing again. Go through and goal, O'Hara. They get a guy sent off. So we're creating, we can't score. They have maybe their first or second chance to the half in the score. I was offside, but the defenders shouldn't have just stood there. Again, Ashcroft and Connolly, they're only communicating with each other. And by the way, on the sports team last night, if you watched it, Chris Boyd said, we have not been told to play offside all season. So it's a issue in the defence. There's obviously no listening to the manager. So that has to be sorted. Somebody walked in. What was I saying? And luckily with the last few minutes the old boys scored to make it 2-2. And then Morgan back down the road with a point against 10 men. They need 10 men for a good 35 minutes of the game. So that's another 2 points dropped. And then Ross County at home, you're expecting at least a point. I go in, get my pie as usual, sit down, and within about a minute and a half sitting down, we're doing 1-0. Right, so I think, again, early goal. What have we got to do now? Kick off again, give the ball away up the pitch, 2-0. I don't know what it was, 2-0 inside 3 minutes and 21 seconds or something. And there's fans leaving the stadium inside 3 minutes of the game. Jesus Christ. That is the worst game I've ever watched. I don't even know what I'm probably talking about. 3-0 down after, what is it, 21 minutes. See the defending, man? They need to get it sorted out. See this bloody tapping it round the back and then See, no, with this whole keep the ball high pressure mince, it's not happening. See, when McDonald plays out for the back, the defenders are too slow. You play it out to whoever, and as soon as we pass that to that defender, they've got two or three players on them already. That is what's happening. They know that we've got to play it for the back, and we're just losing. We're losing it for the back four every single time, and that's how we're conceding goals. Especially Conley's the worst for it, I think. The two centre backs are worse for it. I wouldn't say the wing backs, because he doesn't really play it wide so much, plays it in the middle. To Conley and Ashcroft or whoever it bloody is. So it was Conley's fault for the second goal. The first goal was a bit unlucky against Ross County, a hard deflection, but even still, you shouldn't be getting a striker. No, in fact, not even a striker, any player. That amount of space at the edge of the box. It takes a Ashcroft just chucking himself the ball, which is the right thing to do. And then it's unlocking again in the net. There was a third goal. Conley's fault for the third goal. Second goal was Christ knows. About two defenders just fell in the box, and they've got about two or three guys lined up outside the edge of the box just about to smash it in. So two and a half down inside was 3 minutes or something. Conley's at fault for the third goal because he just, Christ knows what he's doing. McDonald gives him it. As soon as you see you've got a guy on him, just, doesn't matter what you do, just get out of the park, get out for a throw-in, do anything. Don't bloody muck about with it when there's two guys on you. Fourth goal, just terrible marking for a corner. But that is it. I don't think we've conceded any heady goals this year, have we? We conceded one against Dundee. We didn't concede one against Aberdeen. We didn't concede one against Celtic. Who do we have next? Partick. We didn't concede one against Partick. So that was actually the second heady goal that we conceded. All season. There's something on my desk that I'm just trying to get off. But the marking for that corner as well was just horrific. Like, we had, see when it actually gets in, like, it's the goals and everything, you've got two defenders on the post, I think, right? And then you've got Barber running in. What is Barber doing running in when there's only the two guys on the post? Jesus Christ. And then see that second half, I barely watched in that second half. I just had my head in my hands, man. I didn't even want to watch that game. As soon as that second goal went in, I knew they were going to get absolutely thrashed. We only thrashed as much as I thought it was going to be, though. I agree with, again, I've got to mention Gordon's video. He said it could easily be 8 or half time. It probably could have been worse. Again, I agree with Gordon. See, if it wasn't for Jamie McDonald, we'd be losing at least 3 goals a game. At least 3 goals a game. I've no idea what they've got to do. In my opinion, what I would do is I would pay off all the backroom staff, not all of them. I would pay off obviously Gary Lockley, McCall and Peter Leaven, because what they've done there is absolutely heroic. I'd bring in a new manager. I'd bring in Mixu. I'd bring in, I've no idea. Mixu is the only one that comes to mind. But I'd bring in Mixu, bring in, a bit controversial, but I wouldn't mind bringing Alan McCoy then if he had the right, if he had the right way of going around the job. I have no idea what they've got to do. But it's just unacceptable. See, the first was 5 games we've played. Jesus Christ. Dundee. 5 games. First 5 games conceded what? 14 goals. 14 because we've got minus 10. We've got 4. I don't get this. How can we go for coming behind twice to a draw in Celtic to conceding 8 goals at home against Dundee in Ross County. Ross County, what the fuck? Ross County, we're losing in Dundee as well. Wait, how? How are we losing 4-0 to Ross County? It's, I don't even know, man. Anyway, so the second half of this Ross County game is, through what I've seen, Stuart Finlay came on. Cause bloody Jesus Christ, where's 3 injuries in the first half and all? I don't even think half of them were injuries. I think the call just enough because he couldn't be asked. See, after that was it second or third goal, and I think half of the team weren't even caring for the start for the first whistle. The only one that tries in these games is McDonald. Nobody else is interested. See, if what we need, right? Is we need, I tell everybody on the fan page at the start of the season, we need another whole midfield player because Hamill's absolute terrible. McCulloch's no player anymore, he's just, I don't even know what it is. Robinson's injured. We need another left back and all because we'll get, well, nah, we're alright, we're not left back. We only need one. We can just play somebody else there. Jesus Christ. Alright, so we need another centre half. By the way, whilst I'm doing this podcast, when I come in, Peter Wright, I think, has been released by St Johnson, and did Gary Locknell say in his interview the other day that a former player would be coming back to the club or something like that? So it could be him, but I don't want him back, he's too bloody old. Apparently, Sissoko has been training me this week, so I don't know what that's all about. I have no idea what they're going to do. I would, as I said, I would get rid of all the backroom stuff. I would bring in, you know, Mixu, Alan McCoy, maybe. I'm not too sure on that. That might be the right road to go down. But, they'll have to get it sorted because this isn't good enough. How long have we been going for? I've been going for about 17 minutes. Jesus Christ, that was quick. So. I think that's the end of my rambling on. I was going to do a video about my shouting and all this mince, but I just can't really ask, I know. I'm not going to the Berwick game tomorrow. I'm tempted to go to the Motherwell game just to see how bad we are. That's a bad excuse, but... oh my god, I can't even see this right, but I'm no confident about the morning against Berwick. I don't know, man. Just playing terrible and everybody just sick it. So, leave your comments, whatever your opinions. Leave a like if you agree with me, leave your comment, dislike it, tell me why you disliked it. But, geez, this has been the end of the 4th or 5th edition, I'm not too sure. Of the Kill Talk TV podcast. And I'll see you next time on the next podcast, next video, whatever it is. Before I end this video, I'm going to be doing this new series thing called, I don't know if it's going to be called this, but it's going to be a kind of match the experience thing where I just kind of film myself, got the games. I'm probably going to start it either Motherwell. I don't actually know if MDX has got the Motherwell game, so I'm not too sure if I'm going to that. But I'm tempted to go. Who have we got to that? It's bloody Dundee United away, isn't it? Might go to that, I don't know. If we have a different manager in, we'll go to Motherwell, it's basically guaranteed that Locke's going to go. It should be anyway. If we can get another manager in by Dundee United, then I'm tempted to go. But even at that, I have no idea. I've maybe given the new manager a couple of games. But if it's Mixu, all the players should be, you know, buying into it. Everybody was buying into it. Gary Watt was doing it at the start of the season, looking at that talking about. But Mixu knows he's got some discipline. He knows if players play bad, he tells them, and knows Gary Watt wave names at the side of the pitch. As I said, this is the end of the podcast. Leave a like, If you enjoyed, leave your comments below, leave a dislike, and if tell me why if you did. And I'll see you next time. See you later.